In this video, I will show you the steps to create a simple iteration in Abacus CAE. The example is shown here. We will create a cylindrical shell, then perform an iteration with different imperfection types, in this example eigenmode and dimple imperfections, and then we also will create a script which gives us the corresponding results. The problem description is here. We have a cylindrical shell under axial compression. Here is the material in the overall geometry. And here is a corresponding article. Okay. As the next part, we will look into the Abacus model creation. In this part of the video, we will create a numerical model. First, we start in Abacus. We name this to LBA. Then we go to parts, shell, extrusion, create circle, center and perimeter, and first point is 0 and 0. Second point is 0, 33 and 0. Okay, and then extrusion 100. Then we create some planes. Offset for XY is 50. The remaining planes don't have an offset. Then we use partition face use datum plane and partition this shell surface. Okay, now we got a property material manager create steel. Elasticity elastic and the following material data. Then we go to section manager, shell homogeneous and 0.1 thickness. And then section assignment create the whole shell model and done. Then assembly, okay, send to step. Linear perturbation buckle first 10 and then we go to interaction, create reference points with create reference point here one and here one, so at 0 0 0 and 0 0 100. Then we create some sets. RP1 first set and select RP1. Then RP2 and we select RP2. Then set edge RP1 and we select the top edge here, this one, deselect RP1 and we only select this edge and set edge RP2 and the same for the other edge. Okay, then we go to constraint measure, rigid body, continue, tie, then we can select our set. Set edge RP1 and RP1. Okay. And then we can create another set. Tie set RP2 and RP2. Okay, now we go to load. Create initial. Displacement rotation RP1, everything except U3 and initial RP2, everything is locked. Okay, and then we go to load, create step 1 concentrated force and RP1 and CF3 is 1. Then we go to mesh and 0.92 and done. Ok, Okay, and now we create the job. LPA. Okay. And now we can run the analysis. Oh no, first we have to add some stuff. We copy this file first and name it GNIA. Okay. And also we copy a backup file. First we will change some stuff here. General. And then we deselect this one and add here RP1 and add here 0.5. Okay, but now we copy, we create a backup file, backup. Okay, now we go to job. Now we go to edit keywords, LBA, and we add here the above end step. We select the following line, a star, node, file, and U. Okay, now we can run the analysis. And because we added this line in the keyword, we will get an input file with the data for the eigenmode imperfection. Okay, in this part we will create the script for the eigenmode analysis. We go to our Python interface, in this case Spider. Then we create a new file and save it. Eigenmode iteration. Okay, and what we also need is the Abacus and Abacus file. Let's go to the Abacus interface, and the file is called Abacus RPY. Okay, here it is. We select all and delete it and then save. Okay, now we go back to Abacus and we copy our GNIA file, copy model and here one. And then we go back to our Abacus RPY and we can copy all of the stuff here and paste it here. Then we can perform some first step. First we add a string. And modified it slightly. Then we add a loop. This can be deleted and this also. Then we copy the string here, paste it here, and we define this as my model. Okay, and also is okay. Then we need some imports for Abacus. From Abacus import and from Abacus constant import, and we also need NumPy. Okay, let's delete here all and save again. Okay, then we go back to Abacus and we have here the model GNIA. We go to model, edit keywords, GNIA1 and then we go here to end assembly and add star imperfection. Imperfection, Komma, File, LBA, Step 1. Und hier ist, ich choose the first Eigenmode. And for the purpose of comparison, the second and from and the fifth. Okay, and here we can add some scaling factors. Let's add a tenth of the thickness. And here a twentieth of the thickness. And here also. So we have a combination of the first, second and fifth eigenvalue or eigenmode and different scaling factors. Okay. Now we go back to our Abacus API and copy this stuff here. And paste it below. And then okay, and now we add some changes plus a string and then times E. Okay, and here and also for this and for this and but here we add 0.5 and let's choose here times 2e. And here, let's change it like this and times 3. Just to show you what you can do here. Okay, what are we going to do now? We go back to, no, first we delete here everything. And then we go already to job and create a corresponding job file. GNIA1, we activate multiple processors. Okay, now we go back to this Arcos API, copy it here, and then paste it. Then we add here my job, and then we here already. My CPU and my CPU and my CPU and you can choose here a number. And we change the code that is all in one row. Okay, now we copy this one and paste it here. And then we will add some other code here. Okay. Okay, and before we run the job or the script, we have to copy this here and replace this. Okay, now let's try if the script works already and create some models. Okay, now we have created some models. Let's check the keywords if we have the corresponding changes. Yes, you see. If here the changes. Let's check another one, for example 7. Okay. And now we also want to evaluate the script, and therefore we add another stuff. For example, this code which opens the ODB file. The ODB file is the result file of Abacus. And then we want to look at the results of a specific step. Step 1. Okay, and then I have here a loop which I paste. Okay, and what this loop does, it here this variable last step, this loop looks in all steps of step 1, and here it looks for the reaction force at the reference point 1 and also at the corresponding displacement at the reference point 1. And here we have some loops which write the data into a list. And here you can change the 0 is OX, 1 is OY or U2, and 2 is UZ. And the same applies for here. Here it's RF1, RF2, and RF3. Okay, then we add some define some variables here which we need, and also something like this, and here I have this value I save in a corresponding variable. Then I can plot the corresponding data points. Okay, and then we add some more stuff. Here I'm looking for the maximum reaction force. And this is index or number of the reaction force value. And here I save the corresponding displacement, axial displacement as function of maximum reaction force. Okay, and with the final part, I save all stuff into some other lists and then create some text files with the data. Okay, and Then I create some more variables which I need, which are given here. Okay, then we can copy all. And let's delete this stuff here. And we could now paste it here. But first you have to make sure that the linear buckling load results have been completed. Let's look. Here the linear buckling eigenmodes have been already calculated. Of course you cannot run the job before you have completed the LBA. We can also change the scaling factor to 1 and exclude the mesh, and then let's have a look at the eigenmodes. Okay, so I will exclude this from the analysis. This was just this was just to show you that we can use it for the you can use multiple eigenmodes for the iteration, but I don't want to use it. So we just perform the script like this. Okay. I just see that here's an error. You have to select this text here and then press Tab and Shift. So otherwise you loop over the whole text. It has to be on the same column as 4. Okay. What we also can do is maybe add another variable. Let's call it paired. And then replace it here. Okay, now we can use the script, I guess. Copy all and paste it here into the what is it? Command line interface. Here it has to go 1 to 11. Okay, and then the script will perform all simulations. Okay, I have already completed all the simulations. Let's take a look at some of the results. Here we have the iteration with the first, the smallest scaling factor, and here with the largest scaling factor. And you already see that there is a large difference. Okay, then let's also check the corresponding result files, which are here. Here you have the buckling loads and you can just plot them, paste here the buckling loads and here the corresponding scaling factor, and then you can just plot the results. Okay, and the test result, the minimum test result is like this. And you can plot also the test result. Test result. Kilonewton. Und hier ist der Scaling Factor. Mode Imperfection. Okay, in this part we will create another imperfection. We go back to our Abacus interface and then we delete here this stuff. And then we go to our Python. We delete here everything. Save it. And then we create a new script. We copy here everything. And new script. Save as dimple iteration. Then we paste everything and we delete here this stuff. Okay, this will be the same, but we copy here this model again, one. And then we will apply a load here, create step one, concentrated force, and we will apply a load here in the middle with amplitude of minus 0.3. And we will create here an amplitude tabular, 0 amplitude 1, time 1 amplitude 1. Okay, and select it here. And done. Okay, and then we go back to Abacus RPY and let's copy here this stuff. And paste it here. Then we copy my model and replace this SDGR and replace with my model and replace, replace and replace. And let's check everything here. And let's rename the model, let's name it Dimple. And the, we use PERT, paste it here. And now it's 0.3. And then we will run some simulations also. Copy all and paste it here. Then we have an error. Invalid syntax. Cannot remember that here is an analysis. this in a, I don't know where it comes from. What we also should add is here times e, and here a symbol. Okay, now all looks fine to me. Let's copy all and paste it. Okay, it seems to run. In the next part, we look at the results. Calculation is now complete for the dimple imperfection. Let's check the results. Go again to our Vorkos temp. Now we have here the results for the dimple imperfection. Let's paste them here. Dimple. And the corresponding here you can see the typical dimple imperfection behavior of the cylinder buckling nut. Let's add here some lines. Maybe not red. Okay, and also let's check some of the dimple results. Here you can see that we basically don't see the dimple, only at the start of the simulation. And if we check the last one, we have already a very large diamond-shaped dimple. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching and until next time.